저는 오늘 텍사스주 휴스턴의 라이스 대학교에 왔습니다. 미국 명문대 하면 흔히 동북부의 아이비리그를 떠올리는데요. 라이스 대학교는 뉴 아이비 또는 히든 아이비라고 불리는 이른바 신흥 명문대로 자주 거론되는 학교입니다. 2020년 US News and World Report가 집계한 미국 대학 랭킹은 17위였는데요. 경제학, 화학, 컴퓨터공학 등 전공이 전국 15위에 들을 만큼 경쟁력이 높다고 하네요. 캠퍼스는 미국에서 네 번째로 큰 도시, 휴스턴에, 그것도 문화 중심지인 뮤지엄 디스트릭트에 자리 잡고 있는데요. 덕분에 학생들은 활기찬 대도시 문화를 즐기며 다닌다고 합니다. 그럼 남부의 명문, 라이스 대학교를 저와 함께 둘러보실까요? 저는 미스 코리아 USA 수상자이자 최근에 경영대학을 졸업한 조민희입니다. 함께 미국 인류 대학들을 탐방하며 더 깊은 이야기를 들어보고 이 위대한 나라 형성에 어떻게 기여했는지 알아볼 텐데요. 준비되셨나요? 그럼 출발합니다. 아름다운 텍사스주 남동부에 위치한 라이스 대학교는 아울스 또는 부엉이의 고향입니다. 돌아다니다 보면 금방 알 수 있을 거예요. 캠퍼스 곳곳마다 부엉이 조각상이 보입니다. 부엉이처럼 이곳 학생들의 지혜로움을 상징하는 거겠죠? 라이스 대학교를 알려면 그 중심부터 시작하는 게 좋겠죠? 그곳에서 저의 가이드인 빅터 웅우원 씨를 만나서 이 대학교를 세운 설립자의 이야기를 들었습니다.
Welcome to Willie's Statue, the centerpiece of Rice's academic quad. Willie here, or William Marsh Rice, as he's known by his full name, is our university's founder. Way back in the day, in the year 1900, at the tender old cranky age of almost 90, Willie was Houston's most eligible bachelor. No heirs to speak of, and sat upon a massive fortune he had built during his time as a lawyer and down here as a lumber mill proprietor. He decided to leave all his money towards an institute of higher education instead of to anybody else, which sounded absolutely insane, especially when you consider the fact that there were only mosquitoes and oil drillers down here. So Willie actually is buried underneath this statue, making this university the biggest grave site to one singular person in the entire North American continent. No worries though, I can see it in your face. It's not haunted, it's not creepy. He's actually really chill. We decorate him for all sorts of campus events.
비록 장난기는 많지만 라이스 대학교의 학생들은 학문적 우수성을 중요하게 생각합니다. 그들의 오랜 전통도 마찬가지죠.
Which part of campus are we at now?
We're currently at Lovett Hall. This is the very first building built here on campus. Uh-huh. It's also the site of the two most important traditions you'll get, which is all about the Sallyport. So we actually walk through it on matriculation day, your very first day here on campus, as well as walking out of it on graduation day in your caps and gowns, sort of all a right. symbolic way of entering and exiting Rice.
All right, let's go.
Hey, what are you doing?
We're gonna walk through arch.
We? I ain't walking through that arch.
Why not?
There's a superstition behind it. So you only walk in once on matriculation day, and you only walk out once on graduation. So no student will ever step foot in between unless you want to risk not graduating.
Aha, okay.
It definitely applies to me, but feel free to do it if you want.
빅터를 위해서라도 가만히 있어야겠네요. 다음은 라이스 기념센터입니다. 학생들이 커피와 음식도 사 먹고 멋진 부엉이 기념품도 구할 수 있는 곳이죠.
I am so sorry. So you're already on the campus tour. You're in our store. It's time to get you decked out in merch.
All right, let's do it.
Let's go.
상품이 너무 다양해서 쇼핑이 즉흥적인 패션쇼가 돼버렸네요. 포즈를 취해봐요. 저희 멋있죠? 이제는 다음 장소로 이동할 차례입니다.
빅터가 자주 가는 곳이라고 하는데요. 좋은 의미로 이상한 곳이네요.
Look through.
Open sesame.
Whoa! It's super like edgy and fun in here.
Yep. Keep K true weird.
방송국의 표어 KTRU를 늘 이상하게는 빈말이 아니라 진짜입니다. 다양한 학생이 있는 이 대학교처럼 이곳에서도 모든 사람의 취향에 맞는 다양한 음악이 있죠.
This is the main broadcast studio. The majority of our music will be in here.
Hi.
These are some of my co-hosts. Say hi, y'all.
Nice to meet you guys. This is so cool.
드디어 왔습니다. 라이스 대학교 투어에서 라이스 스타디움이 빠질 수 없죠. 가을이 되면 아울스가 경기장으로 나가 미식축구계의 패권을 두고 경쟁하는 곳입니다.
All right, welcome to Rice Stadium.
Thank you, this is awesome.
Yeah, before we get to anything though, got a special guest for you. Hey Sammy, hoodoot!
What? Hi Sammy!
What's up? This is our campus mascot, Sammy the Owl.
This is so awesome, I'm happy to meet you. You told me that you're at the campus store, should we try it out?
Yeah, sure, why not? Sammy, you ready? All right, let's go. 5, 6, 7, 8, R-I-R-I-C-E, R-I-R-I-C-E,
R-I-R-I-C-E.
Yeah, let's go, Rice.
흉내 내는 것도 재미있지만, 라이스 대학교의 진정한 아울스가 되어 날개를 얻으려면 입학에 성공해야 합니다. 더 알아보기 위해 입학 담당 부총장인 이번 로메로 다실바 씨를 만나 자세한 입학 과정을 들어보았습니다.
So what type of student does the university seek?
You know, students at Rice are very committed to learning, and so their commitment to academic excellence is definitely a shared trait amongst our students. But another common trait is that our Rice students really care about one another. You're going to hear more than once about the culture of care here at Rice. And what that really means is that you can have a student body that is pursuing their academic excellence and engaging with faculty, but not at the detriment of their fellow students. In fact, they care about their peers succeeding just the way that they do. And so, regardless of whether you're coming from Asia or the Northeast, you're automatically welcomed into the environment and feel connected to the students who are here.
그 사랑을 몸소 느껴본 사람이 바로 유학생 한예린 씨인데요. 집을 떠나 머나먼 이곳에서 겪은 예린 씨의 이야기를 들어보면 라이스 대학교의 따뜻한 분위기를 잘 알 수 있습니다.
그럼 유학생으로서 힘들었던 점은 있나요?
제가 한국에서만 살다가 미국 유학을 대학교 때 처음 온 거라 처음에는 언어적인 부분에서 많이 어려웠었는데 그 레지던셜 컬리지 시스템 친구들, 1학년 친구들이 많이 도와줬고 그리고 라이스의 캡시라고 언어적인 부분에서 어려움이 있으면 도움을 받을 수 있는 곳이 있어요. 그래서 라이팅도 많이, 그래머 같은 거 많이 도움도 받고 프레젠테이션 스킬 같은 것도 많이 배울 수가 있었어요.
되게 도움이 많이 됐었겠네요.
네.
교수님과 리서치를 하신다고 들었는데 어떻게 시작하게 됐나요?
제가 통계학 쪽으로, 데이터 사이언스 쪽으로 공부를 더 해보고 싶어서 교수님한테 연락을 드렸더니 교수님이 흔쾌히 같이 리서치 해보자고 하셔서 저는 지금 데이터 사이언스 쪽 교수님과 함께 정신분열증 환자 데이터를 갖고 분석하는 리서치를 하고 있습니다.
아, 그럼 데이터 사이언스랑 의료 쪽으로 같이 컴바인하고 싶은 건가요?
네, 제가 지금 데이터 사이언스를 공부한 이유도 의료 쪽으로 가서 병원에서 갖고 있는 환자들 데이터를 갖고 분석을 해서 의사분들과 협업해서 일을 하고 싶은 게 제 꿈이고 최종 목표거든요. 아,
되게 멋진 꿈이네요.
네, 감사합니다.
다양성은 학생층에만 있는 게 아닙니다. 라이스 대학교의 학생들이 들을 수 있는 다양한 강의에서도 찾아볼 수 있죠. 이런 강의는 처음 봐요.
라이스 대학에는 학생들 사이에 아주 유명한 과목이 있다고 하는데요. 바로 몬스터 클래스라는 수업입니다. 특이한 이름 때문일까요? 이 수업에선 무엇을 배울까요?
마이크 거스틴 교수와 데보러 하터 교수는 이 친밀하고 흥미로운 강의실에서 각자의 전문 분야인 생명과학과 인문학을 2인 1조로 가르칩니다.
What is the monster class about?
It's about figuring out who we are by thinking about who and what we fear. And of course, thinking about these issues both from a humanistic and a scientific perspective.
Right, so there's a course title, which is in a sense a type of marketing tool. It's easily identifiable, but the subtext for that is perceptions and misperceptions of the monstrous in various like areas.
This class can be really, really important because it's about how we look at the world and about how the world looks at us.
괴물이라는 은유를 표현하는 방식에는 시각 예술이 있습니다. 이바니아와 조너스는 이 강의를 열렬히 지지하는 학생입니다. 인문학에 대한 다양한 관점을 탐구하기 위해 예술 작품을 만들었다고 하네요.
What I really liked was it was just so easy to distort our silhouettes and so easy to change just our basic perspective.
Right.
In that sense, through pillows and stuffing and various clothes.
What I'm learning from this course is a lot about how we construct and project our fears onto different things, and also how we think about things that are the other or in contrast to the self, and how a lot of us, based on our experiences, we can only know so much in our own life, but through reading and through engaging with these texts and also other forms of media like movies, we can learn a lot more about what other people are going through and how they experience the world.
Almost like, you know, engaging with the monster inside of all of us.
Right. It allows us to see just, you know, the nuances of humanity, and I really, really love this course because of that.
So I think it's a course where we hope the monstrous sort of dissolves in the process of creatively thinking about living in the world with a little bit different attitude.
라이스 대학교의 학생들은 남들과는 다른 태도로 살아갑니다. 아할리아 씨가 가장 좋은 예죠. 아할리아 씨는 장애에도 굴하지 않고 최고 수준의 스포츠 대회인 패럴림픽 경기에 출전합니다.
Alia Lettenberger there in lane 5 is also going incredibly well.
I grew up with a physical disability called arthrogryposis, and swimming has really been a way for me to accept myself and feel like more than my disability. And so I knew that coming to college I wanted to swim, and I decided to come here because of the amazing team as well as my coaches and just the environment at Rice that I could really have a balance between sports and academics.
You must be so busy. What is it like being on the Olympic swim team but also being a student that's heavily involved on campus?
Because of the community at Rice, I've really been able to manage both training and competing and also keeping up with my schoolwork. So even though I'm representing the USA at different competitions around the world and training with the Rice swim team nearly every day to make it to the Tokyo Olympics, the community at Rice and just the amazing professors and students, their support has really allowed me to do everything that I've been doing.
I love your story and very inspirational, and I wish you the best of luck at the Olympics.
Thank you.
Make us proud.
라이스 대학교는 설립 당시부터 가능성의 한계를 밀어붙이고 있습니다. 실제로 50여 년 전에는 라이스 대학교가 달 탐사 경쟁의 중심 역할을 했죠. 데이비드 알렉산더 교수가 더 설명해 주셨습니다.
And how did the university get involved with the space studies?
Rice is just over 100 years old, but for half of that time it's been involved with NASA. So NASA, as many people know, the Johnson Space Center, which is the home of human spaceflight, is here in Houston. President Kennedy, of course, came to Rice in September 1962 to announce publicly that the country was going to the moon.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
One of the founding ideas or concepts of Rice University was it was going to become one of the premier, if not the premier institution for research and education in this part of the country. This was the dream of Rice, and I think over the 100 years or 100 and so years of its life, I think it's lived up to that reputation.
Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
You know, so we've had that long heritage and that long connection, and that has allowed us to build up the reputation we have, build up the kind of science we do, hire in great new faculty, and then grow from there. We're discovering new planets, all of that, all the way down to studying the smallest of atoms and the interior structure of atoms and so on. So it's just astounding, I think.
알찬 하루를 보냈지만 꼭 만나봐야 할 학생이 있다고 합니다. 에리라고 불리는 이 학생은 라이스 대학교의 정신을 담는 눈을 가졌다고 하네요. 저희는 커피를 사서 세 가지 복수 전공과 사진가의 꿈에 관한 이야기를 나눴습니다. 하지만 가장 흥미로웠던 건 한국과 관련된 거였어요.
So you went to Korea.
I did go.
And
to
you
Korea.
Lived there for a while.
For like 6 weeks. I wouldn't go push it too far.
But... Do you know how to speak Korean?
My Korean's super rusty, but I know a little bit.
안녕하세요.
안녕하세요.
제 이름은 조민입니다. 네, 반갑습니다.
반갑습니다.
오늘 하루 어땠어요?
오늘 수업 들었어요.
아, 무슨 수업 들었어요?
Business communication 수업 들었어요. 하고 프랑스 클래스 들었어요.
와, you're 진짜 잘한다.
감사합니다.
와, 한국에서 살았다는 게 정말 느껴지네요.
감사합니다.
엘은 정말 현명한 사람 같네요. 마치 부엉이처럼요.
You know, I also heard about the slogan of the university, unconventional wisdom. Can you tell me more about that?
So unconventional wisdom is more of the slogan of the university, and it kind of talks about this like it quality that like students have here. It's by you pursuing your passions, having your background, having your experiences, and you can just be yourself, and that's what unconventional wisdom is for Rice students in general.
Awesome. Do you want to start your own business in the future? I know you have a very managerial mindset.
Oh yeah, I love entrepreneurship and people who start their own businesses. Actually right now, I am working on a clothing line. It's called Moody.
Are you actually wearing the hoodie right now?
Yes, I am.
I see Moody on your chest.
I'm flexing the brand right now.
It looks so cute and comfy.
It's super soft, super comfy. I designed it completely myself. The dimensions, the stitching, the material choice, the color, all like managed by me, as well as the business aspects, the marketing, the sales, the inventory.
Wow.
So it's been really amazing to like invest a lot of time and effort into this brand, and then being able to like push it out there and see people wear it and invest money. It's so crazy to like think of people want to invest into something that I like put a lot of effort. And so it just means like the world to me.
And you're only an undergraduate student here at Rice, and you're already creating your own brand, building your own business. That is really awesome and very impressive.
Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
이렇게 다양한 학생이 하나로 뭉칠 수 있다니 참 놀랐습니다. 마치 설립자가 이렇게 되도록 계획한 것 같아요.
It's not just an institution. It's a community of people that you feel connected to and a warmth that comes from it that makes this whole place special.
Everybody at Rice is super accepting, and I'm just really getting a well-rounded education to allow me to pursue all my dreams.
Everyone's here to support each other. Everyone's just out trying to make people feel comfortable and feel welcome and feel at home here.
And I'm constantly amazed at the level at which Rice is operating. Pick a topic, and you're somebody here at Rice who's at the top of that game. And, you know, and that, for a small university particularly, that's quite impressive.
All for Rice's honor, we will fight on. We will be fighting when the day.
고대 그리스에서는 부엉이가 행운을 상징했습니다. 휴스턴에서도 다르지 않죠. 이 공동체에는 행운의 기운이 가득해서 단 하루뿐이었지만 이곳에 온 것도 행운처럼 느껴집니다.